Konanda. It's my immense pleasure to introduce the today chief guest of this national level seminar on role of biotechnology in conservation of genetic resources. Dr. E. Palaveshan sir, the professor and head Department of Animal Science, MS University, Tirunelveli, to present the topic Bioactive Potential of Seaweed Polysaccharides. He is a right person to deliver this topic. Success is a wonderful, eminent personality. Sir did his MSc, Bharathidasan University, Trichy, MPhil MKU, and PhD program in MKU. He got various fellowships in his careers, the Senior Research Fellow, UGC, 1985 to 87, Senior Research Fellow, CSIR, 1987 to 90, Postdoctoral Research Fellow, CSIR, 1991-1995. His area of the research, the animal physiology, fish physiology, nutritional biochemistry, and immunology, bioprocessing, fermentation, marine microbial enzyme, and genetics, then probiotics, and so on. The teaching experience, 21 years. The research experience, 24 years. The research guidance, the PhD awarded, 31. The submitted one, the 7 ongoing on. The MPhil produced 101. The 146 paper published in reputed journal with impact factor. The series published various paper in various conferences in international 168, national 49, and proceeding 25. The sir is received many awards, the Tamil Nadu Senior Scientist Award 2016, Citation Award 2016, UGC PSR One Time Grant Award 2014, PK Thos Best Faculty Award 2012, MDT Investigator Award 2012, the Academic Excellence Award 2018, the UNESCO Biotechnology Fellowship Award 1998, UGC Indo-Grace Consulate Exchange Award 2003. The sir is nominee in various academic bodies. The member in syndicates MSU 2015 to 2016. The advisor ASRP 2011. The sir has completed the major research project, the worth of more than 1 crore, in various funding agencies like DRDO, UGC, DST, DPT. He is right person to deliver this topic. With this, I conclude my introduction of the today chief guest. Thank you. Konanda.
So we welcome the keynote speaker, Dr. A. Palaveshan, to throw more knowledge on bioactive potentials of seaweed polysaccharides.
Yeah, at the outset, I would like to thank the organizer for giving me an opportunity to share my experience, what I have, what my research scholars and my colleague Dr. Emmanuel, we did work on the seaweed polysaccharides, and during a tsunami affected season also, we have done considerable work on seaweed cultivation in the southwest and southeast coast of India. With this knowledge on seaweed cultivation, and today I am going to present my lecture on bioactive potential of seaweed polysaccharides. And in brief, and I am going to give you a brief introduction about what are seaweeds and what are the various classes of seaweeds and uses of seaweeds. And this is all for having a simple refreshment, and we, as a biologist and a life science student, so either a botany or zoology, or even a biotechnology, and in one way or other, and we have studied seaweed and seaweed and its biopotential. And with this later part, I am going to tell you that what are the results, research work, and we have carried out in our laboratory, and also salient findings what we have achieved in this, and the mode of action of seaweeds in each and every aspect, whether it is antiviral or antibacterial or immunomodulatory activity, And even at gene level, and this polysaccharide playing an important role in controlling and the expression of particular genes. And with this brief introduction, and I am going to my, shall I have my second slide? What are seabeds? And seabeds are the simple plants in of the sea, and they are the primitive plant distributed in ocean from the tidal level to a considerable depth, floating freely, are attached to a substrate with the hold fast. Seabeds are the wonder plants of the sea, since they are efficient converter of solar energy through a constant nourishment from the surrounding water. And by utilizing the solar energy, and it is producing the green biomass for this marine environment, and it is in turn used as a food for the other consumer level. Some of the seabeds grow faster than that of the terrestrial plants, and in sunlight, surface water of the sea, and they grow up to 40 to 16 times than the original weight during 45 days of culture period. And this data I have witnessed on my own experience, that when we did the Capapicus alvarezi cultivation in the Kanyakumari coast, and we have recorded nearly over to 12 times growth when within the 30 to 35 days. Seaweeds are also considered as a source of bioactive compounds and produce great variety of secondary metabolites characterized by broad spectrum of biological activities. And today, majority of my talk is going to that of on the biological activities. Next slide. Yeah. And if you see that the classes, major classes, and everybody knows that is broadly classified into three different classes, and the red algae, prawn algae, and green algae. As far as red algae is concerned, this dominated by the this nearly about nine species, of which the Gracilaria is a dominant one. Next to this Hyphenium is Hyphenia, and the third one is the Euchema. And as far as red algae is concerned, and the prawn algae is concerned, it is dominated by Sargassum vitae, and then Turbinaria, Laminaria, and Antaria, and Ascophyllum, and Microcystis. As far as green algae is concerned, this alva is the dominating. Next to alva is the Calaba and the Codium, and also the Monostroma. And it is only to have an idea, rough idea, and also to refresh yourself, seventh, what are the various classes of seaweeds. Next slide. Yeah, these are all the dominant seaweed species which are available in the southeast coast of India: Sargassum vitae and Sargassum triplicatum, Sargassum polycystum, and Sargassum tenerimum, and Turbinaria ornata, and Gracilaria edulis, and Gracilaria corticata, and Alva latuca. And these are all the varieties which we often come across, and these are not the only species, and these are all the dominant species which are widely available in the southeast coast of India. Next slide. Yeah, you see the world production of the seaweeds. The world production can on up to 12 million tons worth of US dollar, $8.0 million US dollar. And the world leader, as far as seaweed is concerned, the world leader is China, and other seaweed producing countries are next to China, Japan, South Korea, Philippines, and Indonesia. And those countries have also producing considerable amount of seaweeds through natural environment, and also in majority of the cases through cultivation, seaweed cultivation methods. Next slide. The world standing stock, if you see the world standing stock pertaining to that company, brown algae, red algae, and is the brown algae is dominating with 1,460 million tons, and red algae is nearly about 261 million ton. The world production through seaweed cultivation, and whatever the stock is a natural process and seaweed cultivation potential is concerned in quantity, and throughout the world there is never 11 million tons of seaweeds are cultivated through standard culture methods, and its value is of $6.5 million US dollar, and the total number of species and they have explored for the cultivation is more than 2000 species. The number of species in commercial cultivation is 221, and the number of species explored for food production, human food, is 145, and the number of there's a seaweeds which are exploited for the phytoplankton are 110. Next slide. Yeah, our India's potential, our assumptions considering the quantum of areas and which we are having the protected marine environment, and the total area is available near about 200 hectares lakh is available, and 200 lakh hectares, it is nearly about 0.001% of exclusively economic zone. The average production at the rate of 5 ton per hectare per year, nearly about 10 lakh tons, it's a value of nearly 100 crores. By doing the cultivation and there's employment opportunities, nearly 20,000 employment coastal community get employment opportunities. The annual income, it is the highest amount is 50,000, and what we experience when we are virtually entering into the seaweed cultivation technology, propagation of seaweed cultivation technology among the coastal community, 35,000 to 50,000 is the range. Family, both husband and wife, virtually they involved in the seaweed cultivation practice. And the number of species which are available as per our Indian scenario is concerned, red algae is 434, brown algae is 194, and green algae is 216. Yeah, this is this map showing the seaweed vegetation and throughout the maritime states and the coastal area, starting from this Gulf of Kutch and up to this Bay of Bengal, and throughout the coastal belt you could be able to find out the seaweed vegetation. This is a vegetation area. And as far as Tamil Nadu is concerned, Mandamam, Tuticorin and Trichandur and Manapad, Idindagarai, Kanyakumari and Muttam. And these are all the places where we could be able to find out the dominant nature of these seaweeds in Tamil Nadu, as far as Tamil Nadu coast is concerned. Yeah, this is the bioactive compounds from marine seaweeds, and as far as bioactive compounds are concerned, innumerable bioactive compounds are produced in the seaweeds, and from your right hand side onwards, if you start watching this as a pigment, innumerable pigments are produced by the seaweeds, such as carotenoid, chlorophyll and phytocyanin. And in addition to that, seaweeds are all the rich sources of lipids, and these are sources of essential polyunsaturated fatty acids. And in seaweeds, you can also get proteins and the synthesis of essential amino acids. And seaweeds also rich sources of vitamins A, B, C, D, E, K. And also the innumerable minerals, also micro as well as the macronutrients. Mineral are also large amount of minerals also available on the seaweeds. And this one of the important point is here is the polysaccharides. The polysaccharides is widely used for various industries, from food industries and pharmaceutical industries and cosmetic industries. And it is used as a gelling agent as well as the thickness is a polysaccharide. And other bioactive substances and polyphenols and phytocyanins, and they are also present in the seaweeds, and these are all the various compounds which are available in the seaweeds. Next. Yeah, uses of seaweeds as well. Also, this is you might have studied in at various level, and to have your refreshments. And seaweeds are popularly called sea vegetables, rich in minerals, vitamins, and therefore seaweeds are considered as a medicinal food of 21st century. And seaweed products such as agar, algin, creatinine and bioactive compounds have numerous applications in food, beverages, pharmaceutical, chemical, cosmetics and textile industries, and they also exhibiting strong base for as a growth promoter for variety of plants, and because of this particular characteristic feature, and seaweeds are oily instead of the biofertilizer, and seaweed sap are produced on larger quantity and with lesser amount of preservatives and other things, or they can be used without preservatives directly as a biofertilizer. Seaweeds are found to be one of the major source of bioactive compounds and yielded molecules of anti-HIV, even anti-HIV drugs and other deadpool, and also for other deadpool diseases. Scientists are still discovering one source of seaweed product, and they are expected to set new frontiers, and it will unreveal many applications both in food and non-food industries. Seaweed provide a shelter for a variety of organisms and enhance the biodiversity. This is one of the important roles played by the seaweeds in natural environment and giving protection to the large variety of marine organisms, so as to enhance the biodiversity apart from giving it nourishment. They also absorb carbon dioxide and reduce the global warming, and they are also efficient in controlling the organic pollution, including heavy metals and heavy metals in the near shore and inshore areas. And we might have heard that is the phytoremediation in one of the natural phenomena which is exhibited by the seaweeds in the natural environment to reduce the pollutant which is entering into this aquatic environment, in particular marine environment, through accidentally or through industries or through various human activities. Next slide. Yeah, these are the three important therapeutic compounds which are already obtained and standardized as far as seaweeds are concerned, and collard bean and 2-beta-3-alba, that is ebitenoidal, and also the terapins, and these are all the compounds which are already standardized, and they are produced in large quantity, oily, used in the pharmaceutical industries for therapeutic purposes. Next slide. Now I am coming to our main topic. This is a polysaccharides from the seaweeds. As far as polysaccharides are concerned, polysaccharides are polymers of simple sugars linked together by the glycosidic bonds, and is the polysaccharide prone and lit algae are the most important, most prominent source of marine derived polysaccharides. Major polysaccharides are used as commercial food ingredients, inputs agar agar, arginic acid, sodium alginate and picaridin. Agar agar is being extracted from this jelly and Gracilaria, hybenia and other seaweed species. Arginic acid is extracted from sargassum and laminaria species. Sodium alginate is from sargassum and Gracilaria, and picaridin is from the sargassum, laminaria and ficus species. And these are all the major polysaccharides which is extracted from the seaweeds, and it is widely used in various industries. Next slide. Yeah, this slide shows the stages involved in the preparation of agar agar, and this is a standard method, so I don't spend much time on this aspect. And I'm following the standard procedures, and after collection of seaweed from the natural environment, it has to dried into powder. The powdered material has to be undergone various stages for soaking, and also the grinding and the leaching and various process, and the final end product is the agar agar. It's a standard method. Next slide. Yeah, the potential application of agar agar. As far as agar agar is the most potential gel forming agent, it is used to confrontatory agents, and it is used to clarify wine, juice and vinegar. Agar gel can withstand high temperature without disintegrating, and are therefore used in many canned meat product, and to preserve their quality. In Japan, agar is used to make clear noodles. And agar is also used as a binder for medicine, and in particular for the preparation of tablet and capsules. agarose which contains hydrophilic properties make it good moisturizing additives for bread making, and it is used in piping jellies and it is also used as a filler in food industries. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, this next one is the preparation of arginic acid, and this is the various steps involved in the preparation of arginic acid. And since it is also a standard method, it is available and everywhere in standard protocol. And we have also published a lot of papers pertaining to the production of agar agar arginic acid, and including picardin and sodium arginate. And since it is a standard one, and it has to be properly collected, dried powder. Dried powder is used for acidifications, and then it is heated at 100 degrees temperature, and wash it thrice with water. And final product is the arginic acid, and this is a standard method. Next slide. Yeah, preparation of sodium alginate. This is also again, this is the various steps involved in the preparation of the sodium alginate, and from fresh seaweeds, and we have to try it into powder, and take the seaweed powder treated with HCl and reduces the pH and incubate it overnight, and wash it above content in the water, and extract with the sodium carbonate and for overnight. And then further, it bleaches the extract with the 2.5% of sodium hypochlorite, and evaporate the content at 60 degrees centigrade at whatever oven, and whatever the remaining end product we are getting is the sodium alginate. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, uses of this alginate. Alginate have water holding and gelling and emulsifying, and also the stabilizing function, and that is why it is widely used in the food industries. It stabilizes the ingredients of tablets, and it's also added as a protective cover to the tablets, and it is used in the pharmaceutical industries, and it is used in hair setting compositions in the cosmetic industries. And used for artificial bait for fishes and shellfishes, and this is sodium alginate is artificial bait, and also alginate is used as a thickening agent in the preparation of the fiber reactive paste, and this is also used as a personal care product such as a shampoo, cosmetic, conditioner, and exfoliating shower gel, etc., etc., as a cosmetic agents. And calcium alginate is widely used as a manufacturer of medicinal dressings and the wound healing agents, and as well as a panic killer. And sodium alginate improves the blood glucose tolerance and increases the cholesterol excretion. And hence, it is widely used as blood glucose control, and also to reduce cholesterol. And sodium alginate is used also an immune modulator, and based upon these properties, it is widely used as an immune modulator in particular in the aquaculture industries as a feed additives. Yeah, antiviral activities of sodium alginate, and we did experimentation on the effect of sodium alginate extracted from sarcasm vitae, and this sodium alginate extracted from the sarcasm vitae was enriched with Artemia napoli. This is a bioencapsulation technique, and the bioencapsulated Artemia napoli was fed to the Pinnaeus monodon larvae. And after feeding it with a set duration, you know, to 20 days, and the well-fed organisms, Pinnaeus monodon, was challenged with the white spot syndrome virus, and this is one of the main deadly virus. It is causing great damage to the aquaculture industries, and that is why research all over the world, and they are trying to find out their molecules and which can able to control the WSSV in the aquaculture operations. Having it in our mind, and we have used this sodium alginate bio gas related Artemia anopheles for combating up WSSV, and we found out that this 100 mg and 400 mg per liter of this sodium alginate fed this Pinus morodon showed better that is survival when compared to that of the control. In control, 100% mortality was occurred in WSSV, even though that WSSV was challenged, and due to the addition of sodium alginate, and we could be able to recover near about 50%. We can able to stop near about 50% mortality when using 40 mg of sodium alginate per liter. Next slide. Yeah, preparation of picardon, and this is one of the important and most significant polysaccharides, and which we are obtaining the brown seaweed. And this is the various steps involved in the preparation of the picardon. By adapting appropriate technology, and we can prepare the crude picardon, and also after having the further steps, and we can purify this picardon. As far as picardon is concerned, the low molecular weight and high molecular weight picardons are there, and by adapting appropriate technology, only the two or three steps, and we have to do differently for low molecular weight and high molecular weight picardons, and we can isolate picardon in total, or we can also isolate low molecular weight and high molecular weight picardon. These are the standard methodology already standardized, and it is available in our research paper, and also the research paper published by other researchers on picardon. Next slide. Yeah, applications of picardon. As far as application of picardon is concerned, picardons are highly sulfated polysaccharides of brown algae, possess diverse biological activities. Picardon have pharmaceutical activities such as antibacterial, anti-lipidemic, anti-accident, anti-cancer, anti-diabetic, wound healing, immunosuppressive, and also the anti-coagulant activities. And by weaving this, and we can able to just imagine the potential role played by the picardon, and the efficiency of picardon is based upon the molecular weights of the picardon, and also the sulfate as well as the fecose, which is available along with that of the picardon. It is a heteropolysaccharide. Along with the sulfate and fecose are also available, and the concentration of sulfate and fecose is also playing an important role in the efficiency of this picardon. Apart from its molecular weight, either low molecular weight picardon or high molecular weight picardon. Picardon from adenosine altriclarians have showed antiviral activities against HSV-1 and HSV-2. Picardon were also found to inhibit replications of several enveloped viruses such as human immunodeficiency and human cytomegaloviruses. And this is also playing an important role in antiviral properties. Picardon was used as an immunomodulating agent in aquaculture operation, in particular for the finfish and shellfish culture. Picardon was also used as a wound healing. It is also a wound healing agent because of its wound healing property. Next slide. Yeah, this in our laboratory, we did certain experimentation on effect of picardon isolated from the sarcasm bethi. And these are two group of rats. We are, one is they are rat with a normal diet, and the second group is rat fed with 100 mg per kg picardon at regular intervals for about 20 days. And this wound was created, and the wound healing efficiency was observed both in control and experimental organisms. And from this photographs, and you could be able to visualize that there's experimental animals after 15 days itself, the rate of wound healing than compared to that of the control group. In control group, even 10 and 15 days, the wound was at larger portions. And after when it is fed with the picodon, it is aiding the process of wound healing. The process of aiding wound healing, it is not a direct process. And the report says that the picodon playing an important role in acceleration of antioxidant system. By enhancing the antioxidant system, and it reduces the inflammation, and through which it is aiding the process of wound healing. Next slide. Yeah, this is a histological analysis of wound, and we want to find out and what is happening during the course of wound healing action on the fifth day of wound healing. And what you are seeing from your right hand side is the control group, and is the left hand is this is the wound, this is the epithelial tissues of the wounded area. On the fifth day and the tenth day, you can able to visualize, differentiate the histological changes, the morphological changes which is recovered during the course of wound healing process. And this was at a faster rate when compared to that of the control group. And here that the epithelial layer and also the follicle, and this follicle, hair follicles, development of hair follicles are also at a faster level in the experimental group when compared to that of the control. Next slide. Yeah, this is the 15th day and 20th day, and you can able to easily visualize in the control group the whatever the changes which we are observing is there is a natural phenomena. And in the epithelial, a well developed this epithelial layer, and also the hair follicles on the 20th day of the organism fed with the picodon at the rate of 100 mg per kg. And it indicated that this picodon is aiding the process of wound healing and by accelerating the antioxidant enzyme system. Next slide. Yeah. And this is the research article published by Murakami et al. In the year 2010. They have used the three different polysaccharides, that is alginate and picodon, along with that of the chitosan. Chitosan is also used for the preparation of the hydrocell sheet. The prepared hydrocell sheet out of alginate, chitin, and also the picodon was used to test its efficacy on the wound healing process. And this lowest panel is the control group, and middle one is the standard drug and used, and the uppermost panel is the hydrocell sheet of ACF hydrocell sheet. ACF is nothing but the arginic acid, alginate, chitin, and picodon. That is a hydrocell sheet, and the hydrocell sheet prepared out of this is seaweed polysaccharide showed better efficiency when compared to that of the even the standard hydrocell sheet which is available in the commercial market. Next slide. Yeah, this antibacterial activities, and so I told you that is a picodon playing a vital role in antibacterial activities. And in the more recent days, the picodon, in order to have the better efficiency, the picodon is used to go one step ahead, that is a synthesis of silver nanoparticle, picodon silver nanoparticle. And when the silver nanoparticle, the picodon directly and also in the form of silver nanoparticle, it is playing an important role in the self-proliferation and multiplication of the pathogenic bacteria. And in the first stage, it is break down the cell wall of the bacterial cell wall, and later on, and it is involving in their multiplications of this bacteria, and ultimately the death of the bacteria will occur in due course, and it will be eliminated from that of the particular environment or from the host organisms. Next slide. Yeah, the antiviral activity of what is antiviral activities and immunomodulatory activities of the picodons and We have did various experiment in our laboratory also as to find out the antiviral as well as the immunomodulatory efficacy of the ficodon. The ficodon isolated from the sarcasm VT was supplemented with the billet diet and fed to this Pinnaeus morodon. It is one of the commercially important fish as far as marine organism is concerned for about 45 days. After 45 days of the feeding experiment, and it was challenged with WSSV, and there was a reduction in mortality, and nearly about there's a 100% mortality in the WSSV challenged organisms which were received controlled diet. In the experimental diet received organisms, the mortality was raised to that of the 50 as well as the 68% even at the concentration of 0.1 and 0.3% of the ficodon when it is supplemented along with the feed as a feed additive. During the challenge experiment, the immunological parameters such as the total hemocyte count, phenol oxidation time, respiratory first, superoxide dismutase, phagocytic activities were also assessed, and it indicated that through accelerating the antioxidant system and all the enzymes involved in the antioxidant system, and this ficodon is enhancing the immune modulation, and in addition, therefore it is reducing the mortality. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, what is the mechanism, actual mechanisms involved? This is action mechanism of seaweed polysaccharide as far as antiviral inhibitory is concerned. And this first mechanism is, this is sulfated polysaccharides. I already told you this is a sulfate heteropolysaccharide containing sulfate and vicose. And the sulfate group of the polysaccharide binds with this sulfate group on the polysaccharides. They are all the negatively charged molecules. And when it is combined with the positively charged molecules, that is called particular amino acids of V3 loaf of viral envelope, that is glycoprotein. Because V3 loaf of viral envelope is essential for the viral attachment on the host cell surface, and therefore when the ficodon positively charged sulfate group, it is combined with that of the negatively charged sulfate group of polysaccharide in the ficodon combined with the positively charged V3 loaf of amino acids, and this site is blocked and it is prevented from the from attaching to the host system. Therefore, the virus could not invade it into the host system, and in due course it will be eliminated from this. This is one of the foremost important phenomena through which this polysaccharides, in particular ficodon, is inhibiting the viral molecules for in attaching the host system. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah. And this figure represent this the various stages or various steps involved in the antiviral mechanisms, and the antiviral mechanisms are of various types, and this various stages involved in viral cycle inside a host systems are: first one is viral attachment, then viral penetration and uncoding, and then biosynthesis within the cells, and then viral assembly, and then viral release. And these are all the natural phenomena which occurred in the when the virus molecule is entering the host system. And when the polysaccharides were used as a natural product, and it inhibits the virus attachment as the first point, as I already told you, from the attachment site itself in the uppermost things, and you could be able to see that one is a seaweed polysaccharides, polysaccharide blocks the attachment of the virus in the host cell. That's the first things. Second, it inhibits the virus penetration. It won't allow the virus to penetrate into the system. It inhibits the virus internalization and uncoding. And third, fourth one is inhibit virus transcription and replication process inside the host cell, and through which what is happening, there's a virus cannot able to multiply and it decodes and it will be eliminated. And these are all the various mechanisms through which the ficodon playing an important role as a antiviral role, and preventing the virus molecules entering into the host system. Next slide. This anti-diabetic activities is one of the important activities. This polysaccharides in particular picodons used, and this work was done by Joy and Kuchan in the year 1999, and they have done this anti-diabetic activities of the picodon. And it is a normal group and without any induction of the diabetic. It's a diabetic controls. The diabetic is induced by the either alexion or that is alexion and or ceftriaxone. And then this diabetic induced animals were fed with 100, 200, 300, and 400 mg/kg picodon orally to that diabetic induced rats. And they observed that, and what has happened to that cholesterol level, blood glucose level, and also the triglyceride level. And they found out that the maintenance of the blood glucose level maintenance was found to be controlled by the addition of picodon to the host animals, and it was found to be the concentration dependent. Next slide. Yeah, this is the experimental design. Next slide, please. Yeah, and this is the blood glucose level. The blood glucose level was in the previous slides, and you could be able to see the role of picodon on blood glucose level. And the total cholesterol level was also controlled over that of the control, compared to that of the control. And triglyceride level was also at a normal level when the picodon was administered along with the diet orally. And here, this signaling pathway, main signaling pathways recruited blood glucose level. How this picodon playing an important role in controlling the blood glucose level in the sense, and the reactions at mitochondria levels, and reactions at endoplasmic reticulum level, and reaction even on the nuclear level, and reactions on the membrane level. And these four different reactions, they are virtually entering into the various metabolic pathway by controlling the key enzymes which regulating their metabolism, both either is carbohydrate metabolism, and through which, and it is controlling the blood glucose level. And another one hypothesis proposed was, and this picodon playing a vital role in accelerating the insulin secretions by rejuvenating the beta cells in the islets of Langerhans of pancreas. And it is directly involving in the anti-inflammatory activities of the beta cells of islets of Langerhans, and thereby it is enhancing the insulin secretions. And it is also playing an important role in the calcium homeostasis, and the insulin secretions and calcium homeostasis as playing a very key role in the release and the entry of insulin inside the cellular membranes to control the blood glucose level. And by modulating this, modulating the enzymes and involved in the various metabolic pathway, and picodon playing an important role in controlling the blood glucose level. Next slide. Next slide. And we have also found out that how this diabetic affected the liver cells, and what is the role of picodon. And we have used two different concentration of picodon, 100 mg/kg and 200 mg/kg of picodon, and it was orally administered to the diabetic induced rat. And we found out that this normal cell structure were regenerated at a faster rate in organisms received picodon at the highest concentration of 200 mg/kg, and this recovery is comparable to that of the standard drug metformin. Next slide. Yeah, it's a kidney also. We have studied the kidney. It's normal glomerulas in the control. In the control diet, is the glomerulus is normal, and there are small cavities are also there. And when it is the diabetic induced, the glomerular structure cluster is entirely disrupted and damaged. And when we are adding the picodon at the rate of 100 mg and 200 per mg kg, there's a normalization of coloma cell is occurred, and it is comparable to that of the picodon. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, this is the pancreas. The pancreas is responsible for the insulin, is isolates of Langerhans and then beta cells. And during diaptic induction, the isolates of Langerhans and beta cells are greatly damaged. And when the organisms were fed with picodon at the rate of different concentration, 100 and 200 mg per kg, and this is a regeneration of the beta cells and isolates of Langerhans, and thereby it is ameliorating the synthesis of insulin in the diaptic rat. Next slide. Yeah, this picodon is also playing an important role as an anti-ulcer activities, and we did certain experiment on the efficacy of anti-ulcer, and this anti-ulcer mechanism is mainly through the accelerating the various immunological parameters and also the gut microbiome, in particular the probiotic microbes. Picodon playing an important role in as an anti-ulcer activity. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, this is a normal stomach, intact stomach, and the smooth muscles and the gastric gland and also the cavity. And this what central picture see the normal stomach of the normal stomach. And in the diaptic induced diet, you could be able to see there is an abnormalities in the smooth muscles and gastric gland and also the cavity, and the cavity is reduced much. And when the picodon is administered, and it aided the normalization process, that is, it ameliorated the changes which were already occurred due to the diaptic induction of diaptic. And the stomach ulcer become getting normal, and it is comparable to that of the standard drug omeprazole. Next slide. And the duodenal ulcer, we have also studied the impact of picodon on duodenal ulcer. And here we could be able to find out that this intestinal epithelial villi, this is a normal development of intestinal epithelial villi. This is a smooth muscle, and in the diaptic control treated with the saline, and you could be able to find out the abnormalities in the intestinal villi. And when compared to that of the control, and in the picodon administered one, and we could be able to find out that the regeneration of the intestinal villi as well as the normal functioning of the smooth muscles when compared to that of the standard drug omeprazole. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, this is immunomodulatory mechanisms, and we have studied something about the immunomodulatory mechanisms. As far as immunomodulatory mechanism is concerned, the three different motifs are there, such as the beta binding protein motif, and then polysaccharide beta protein binding motif, and those motifs jointly is responsible for the acceleration of phenol oxidase enzymes, and which is responsible for the immune modulation activities, whatever it is happening in the host system when administered with the picodon. And we have did experimentation on to assess the immunomodulatory efficacy, and whether it is not only playing an important role at the antioxidant enzyme systems and immune modulation, and it is also playing an important role even the expression of immune genes, immune genes, and therefore modulating the immune modulations or immune activity. Next slide. Next slide. Now, this is the experimental setup and control and the experimental diet prepared with the picodon, and it was challenged with the WSSV, and the intramuscular injection was also given with with that of the WSSV, and it was grown, and finally we found out this immune gene expression. Next slide. Yeah. This is by using RT-PCR, and we found out that there's a uses, what is the functions of this fecodon sodium alginate and alginic acids on the expression of this is a WSSV copy number, and this WSSV copy number and how it is reduced much by using the RT-PCR value. And in the control you could be able to find out that is the threshold, that is a threshold PCR cyclic value is 16.96, and the WSSV number is 1.42 × 10⁶ in the positive control group where it is injected with the WSSV. When in those organisms which after injection fed with the fecodon sodium alginate and alginic acid at a different concentration, and we could be able to find out that the threshold PCR cyclic value is enhanced to a considerable level, and it is an indicative of the reduction in the WSSV DNA copy number. And there is an inverse relationship between the threshold PCR cycle value and also the WSSV DNA copy number. And this was also hold good for the sodium alginate and alginic acid. When compared to that of the sodium alginate and alginic acid, fecodon play an important role in controlling the WSSV when compared to that of sodium alginate and alginic acid. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, this slide is related to that of this RT-PCR value, and that is amplification curve and standard curve of this serial dilution of the standard control and a different concentration of the seaweed polysaccharide fecodon in experimental animals. And these were analyzed through rotor gene operation software version and 1.7.6. And based upon that, we have calculated the threshold. Threshold PCR cyclic value, and we found out that the phenol oxidase gene expression was accelerated at a higher level when it was fed with fecodon at the concentration of 0.19, 0.2, 0.3. Percentage per 100 gram feed, and it indicated that even the addition of fecodon through the diet, and it accelerated the phenol oxidase gene expression. And you are all aware that phenol oxidase is an important enzyme, and that play a vital role in regulating the antioxidant systems, and it is also responsible for the particular gene expression. Next slide. Next slide. Yeah, this is the value I already told you. There's a relative quantification of phenol oxidase enzymes. Now, there are some merits and unique structural and functional entities of the marine-based seaweed polysaccharides. And overall, I am going to conclude that merits of the marine-based seaweed polysaccharides, and it is available in abundance from the natural environment, that is inertness in nature, and biologically tunable, and it is biocompatible, and this whatever the compounds we are preparing from the seaweed polysaccharides, the biodegradable one, and it is also we are obtaining from the renewable resources as far as seaweed is concerned, and jeweling and colloiding feature is very high as far as seaweed polysaccharide is concerned, and hence it was widely used in pharmaceutical as well in the food industries, in particular food industries. And over and above all, it is non-toxic in nature because we are obtaining from these polysaccharides from the natural environment. It won't create any toxic to the organisms, and easy in processing and extractability. And there are several standard methods are there to isolate and purify the compounds at a desired level. Next slide. In conclusions, I want to conclude that seaweeds are an interesting source of biologically active compounds, and sulfated polysaccharides, in particular heteropolysaccharides, shall be used as a therapeutic agents instead of commercial drugs, and so as to protect the so as to prevent the side effect and also the protect the environment. Next slide. Okay, my research team and Agil Kumar, Ramya, that is Sarnos and Muthulakshmi, Alice Manchu, Suhay, Sulegal, BB, Shivakumar and Manoja, and they are the research scholars, those who are actively involving in isolation and characterization of these compounds. And at present, we are working on the synthesis of nanoparticles because very little information available on the nanoparticles, polysaccharides on these biological activities. Thank you for giving me the opportunities. I am ready to clarify if doubts any.
Thank you, sir, for giving a detailed descriptions on bioactive potentials of seaweed polysaccharides. Thank you, sir. It was really an interesting session and students enjoyed your session. Thank you very much.